going on, guys? It is Wednesday. Yeah, it is Wednesday. The Wednesday after my treatment, 2 days into my recovery. And we're off to town for a little walk in the sun, get some Vit D, you know. So, how am I feeling? Hungover? It's probably gonna hit the nail on the head most. I just feel like my whole body is really like heavy. My head is dizzy. My heart is going faster. Just like walking is more of an effort than it would usually be. But obviously, like, my body's coping with this foreign substance, so it's gonna have to cope somehow. That's just the way it's reacting. And generally, like, when I think of things, when I think of doing things, it takes a lot longer for me to process. Like, I've just been doing a bit of work on the computer, and it's taking me a lot longer. And like tonight, the thought of doing playlists for classes took a lot of brain power. But even like talking like this to the camera, I think maybe you lot can tell that I'm just maybe over here somewhere, not in here. So you might be wondering what like I'm doing with work and stuff. I'm going to work today, and I'm going to go to work tomorrow and the next day, because I want it, because I love it, because I love what I do, and there's no better feeling than doing a day at work. And I mean, the only thing I've really got to be careful is actually like telling, like being honest with myself, because that's what I find hardest, is being honest. Emily, you do not feel well today, do you? And I'm like, no, but today, genuinely, I feel sluggish. Yeah, I feel a bit over here a bit. I'm going to work. I start at 4, so I'm meeting Aisha in town for a little bit, take her for a coffee. I've been treating her quite a bit lately, just to say thank you for being amazing, basically. She's my rock, and if it wasn't for her, then I don't think I'd be sane. So yeah, finish at 9, and that's the plan, guys. So come along with me. I'm going to take you through this whole recovery, and then through the next cycles and the next cycles, because I've got a 2-week gap, and then on to the next one. So yeah. We picked her up. She's the invisible woman today. We're just going to head back, probably have something to eat and chill out for a bit before work, because we've been up since, what time did we get up?
5 or half 5
this morning to get Aisha back to go to work, because we stayed in Bromley another night last night. It definitely was worth it. So it's going to be a long day. So far so good, and the weather is on point. Yeah, overall, feeling alright today. We'll see how it goes after work tonight. Anyway, I'll see you at home. So we just got a little sank for the post from
so
a little someone.
Cool. Yeah, thank you, Jamie.
Thanks, Jamie. It's really sweet.
Spot an amusingly shaped vegetable.
I can spot one.
What? You're rude.
Anyway, let's eat. Thanks, Jamie. See you in the next clip. Oh, Jesus.
How are you anyway, Silvery?
Oh, I'm tired. Finished work, crew. And we are home. What's going on, guys? So one thing that I have noticed is where I have my operation. What?
Can I put your pants down?
No. Okay. Should I? No. When I have my operation, and it goes from here to about there, and I did get quite a bit of lymphedema after the surgery, because they took all the lymph nodes out. What?
What's lymphedema?
Lymphedema is like, lymphedema is retention of fluid and it causes cellulitis, and really bad lymphedema is like loads of fluid underneath your skin and you need it drained.
I didn't even know you got that.
Yeah, I had it really badly.
Oh.
I had to wear a stocking to suck it all in. So after my operation I had that, and for about a year and a half now I haven't had any swelling whatsoever, but I think this treatment has brought it back on, because if you look at my leg, all around there, swollen.
This is a bit awkward.
Don't know if you can see. If you look at that leg, I've got chunky legs anyway, but if you really look at that, it's swollen all around the side.
Look at that good scar.
Yeah.
It is impressive.
So yeah, I'm a bit worried about it, but I think the more I stay active, the more it's meant to flush the water through. So just stay active, sound top of it, and the doctor said if it gets a substantial amount bigger by tomorrow, then they're going to have to drain it. So I might have to go to a hospital somewhere for them to drain it. But hopefully not, all being well, it should just flush through. It's probably just my body adapting to this new treatment. Film lady is on her phone. You're fired. Good night. Good morning, guys. It is 9:15, and we're heading to the gym. Update, leg is swollen. So yeah, I think that's just the lymphedema and where my immune system isn't flushing through the water as well, because obviously this drug affects my immune system more than anything, and my immunity is lower at the minute. So I've got to be really careful with like who I train, who I get close to, all those kind of things. Anyway, so I'm gonna smash a pre-workout. Remember that pre-workout I tried in that video where it tasted like rank? Tasted really rank. Well, I got the same one in apple because it worked really well. And I thought, oh, I'm just gonna try another flavour to see if it's actually just the cherry cola that's rank. And it, well, nice. So I'm happy with that. Happy I listened to the girl in the shop. Let's go and train back in a bit. I'm in my dressing gown, but I had a bit of a potato moment earlier. I forgot my memory card, so I've got no footage of the day, but on a good note, I'm back from work. It is 7:40. I just got dinner on the go and I'm about to jump in the shower. I'm going to show you what we have for dinner and I'm just going to talk you through my recovery, but I'll tell you about it after the shower. See you afterwards. So, we've just had a shower and now we're about to have dinner. So I'm going to show you what we've got downstairs. Aisha's cooking and I think it might be ready.
So we have got on the go. Can I show the crew what you're cooking, babe?
So this is how much of a diamond she is. She comes back from work and she cooks up meals like this. That's what I love her. So she's making a giant salad over here in my favourite bowl. Then we've got over here, we've got salmon fillets, green beans.
No, asparagus.
Asparagus. And then this sauce that's like, what is it? Like a cheesy...
Yeah, it's skimmed milk.
Yeah,
like,
it's basically a low-fat like cheese sauce. And then that's going to go on top of some gluten-free pasta for Aisha. And I might have a bit of this. I don't usually like pasta, but this is gluten-free and it digests so much better, guys. If you have pasta, any of you have pasta, and even if you're not like gluten-free and all this, just try the gluten-free pasta. It is more expensive, but we discovered it. Your mum made us discover it, didn't she? She cooked it out for us. And then we discovered it, and I don't think I'd ever go back, and I don't know if Aisha would ever go back, because it just kind of digests so much better. And now I'm going to have some brown rice to finish off that we had in the fridge. So yeah, really good day all in all. We had a nice line this morning, which made a hell of a difference after yesterday. But yeah.
One of your groupies came to
dress. Oh yeah, one of my groupies. Also, got another groupie. Shout out to Val, you know who you are. She
Val.
Watches as
my
well.
My Val.
Aisha's Val. Everyone who's like coming up to me and saying, oh my God, I watch this video, watch that video, they're so good. That is like my recovery. That's what's pushing me through. And you know, it has caused a bit of some arguments with me and Aisha because I'm constantly doing it. And with my personality, I get so engrossed, so obsessed. So I've kind of like wavered it out to a kind of moderate level, haven't I? And
I think it's because it's not just filming, is it? You have to like go and then edit it.
But yeah, everyone that's coming up to me saying, oh my God, my mate is so addicted to your videos, or I'm so addicted to your videos, that's like, that inspires me. That drives me to still be strong, still, you know, be the best person I can be. Look what we've got. So I've got the brown rice with salmon in the pasta sauce, low fat pasta sauce, and then you've got the gluten-free pasta over here. So here we've got close up, and this is Aisha's favourite meal, isn't it? You do like this, or one of them. And then I'm finishing off this pesto chicken that Aisha's mum cooked the other day with this mammoth salad. And we're gonna enjoy, and I'll see you in about 10 minutes. I was at work earlier and I had a look at side effects. And the main ones that I can really relate to is the hormonal change and skin change. Spots was one. I had a bit of a spot issue yesterday. So that's one I can definitely relate to. Aching joints, I've got that a lot. My elbows ache, my knees ache. The fluid retention wasn't on there, the lymphedema wasn't on there. I'll show you that now, actually. I'm holding water, so that main bit there, I'm holding a lot of water. Like, if I do that with my legs, you'll see that is a lot bigger. So lymphedema is definitely coming back on that. All right, the other one was kind of a sickness feeling. Definitely got that, like just a gurgling in my stomach feeling. But I'm eating no matter, like, you know, I'm just eating because I know I have to eat because of the how active I am. So I'm almost forcing it into me. But other than that, what else? What other things have I had? Fatigue is obviously one, and I've been really fatigued. Like right now, I feel just like bleh.
Well, heart palpitations on Monday and Tuesday.
Like, my heart was like, I was walking somewhere on Tuesday. I think we were just walking to a coffee shop with me, and my heart was pulsing. All I was doing was walking. That's all I was doing. A normal pace, chilled out pace, and it was like doof 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 doof, and I was out of breath. And I definitely felt that in spinning tonight when I was shouting at people, when I was telling them what to do. My heart rate was a lot higher on my monitor. So on average, it's usually about 150 to 155 ish. All the way through, and that my average tonight was like 180, which was really interesting. Anyway, guys, we're gonna hit the sack. I'm gonna see you tomorrow. I know there hasn't been a lot of training footage in the last few videos, but it is coming back. So tomorrow I'm gonna film my workout tomorrow morning, and obviously I've been taking it a lot easier after treatment. But yeah, back on it, and I'll see you tomorrow in a bit, guys. Good night. going on, guys? About to head off to work. I'm about to head into town. As you can tell, I've got my coat on, my rucksack on, ready to go. But I just wanted to kind of wrap up this video and let you know what it was all about. If you've made it this far, then thank you so much for sticking by and watching. This video was probably highly boring because it was just like my recovery week and following me through, going through the motions. Tuesday I didn't get any footage because I was zonked. It would have just been so pointless. Maybe I should have got a bit of a feel. Maybe I should have let you have a feel of how really rough I was feeling. But I just skipped straight to the Wednesday and started filming then. And I was straight back at work on Wednesday, which I'm very happy with. I'm very happy with how the treatment has settled in my body. I feel like I have had cancer treatment, definitely, 100%. I feel like I'm fluey, my joints are aching, my elbows, my knees. I've got spots coming up in weird places, like my back, and just things that I would never expect on cancer treatment. Obviously, this lymphedema has got to me a little bit, but it hasn't swollen up any more than what you saw earlier on in this video. So that's good. That hasn't grown up even more. All in all, the week one of treatment has gone really well, and the fact that I've been able to work the second half of the week, brilliant. Like, that's more than I could ask for. Whether the next cycle will hit me harder, whether it will get worse as time goes on, because they did say it was a matter of topping up the treatment rather than if you having it and you being really ill and then getting better and then being ill again and getting better. It's just a top up and it goes up and up and up. Because it's changing the way that your body is working. Obviously, I have been training a couple of times this week, but it's been really lighter intensity. You might see in that back workout that it was literally just straight sets. Quite a calm workout, just going through the motions rather than actually pushing myself to the point where I'm sweating when my heart rate's really high. My heart rate's high as it is, so I don't want to take it any higher. I'm using training more as of a mental tool at the minute rather than a physical tool, because obviously I am still teaching spin, which is the most strenuous thing for me. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I'm going to sit upright, but I'm going to chop my head off. No, I'm joking. I should have pulled the camera up a bit, but oh well, I can't bother. Thank you so much for watching. See you in the next video. Laters.